arms up, fingertips up, arm circles. I'm not alone today, but you'll hear it. You won't see it, but you'll hear it. Let's just keep it clean, ladies. Keep it clean. And reverse. I really feel like I'm in the spotlight now.
You are.
You know how I feel about that. Fingertips down. Big circles. 10 going backwards. And then 10 going forward. Back and forth 10 times. It's about as loud as I can get the music without getting my hand slapped.
Yeah, that's perfect. All right,
fingers back, or arms back, and up 10 times. And then we're gonna go side to side 10 times. Get those feet hip-width apart, shoulder-width apart. Take a nice deep breath in. Reach all the way up, and then forward fold all the way down. Head, shoulders relax. Take a couple deep breaths here. Take a nice deep breath, coming all the way back up. Right hand, grab the left wrist, pull to the right side. So we don't want to kick our hip out like that. We just want to pull to the side. Reach up nice and tall, grab the other wrist, pull to the other side. Reach up tall, forward fold all the way down. Cross those arms, let the head and shoulders relax. Nice stretch to the back. Just lay side to side here. All the way back up, grab that wrist again, right wrist, or right hand, grab the left wrist, pull to the right side. Reach up nice and tall, left hand, grab the right wrist, pull to the left side. Reach up. Now we're going to come up on our toes, and then back to the heels. On the toes, back to the heels, 15 times. I didn't turn the AC on.
Oh, okay.
You guys get a feel what it's like when I have to work in here, right?
Does it make much noise?
It does make a lot of noise.
All that workout, we might need that AC. Here
in a minute. It'd be fine. All right, forward fold all the way down. Plant the hands to the ground, step back into plank. Just hang out here for a few seconds. Engage that core. And then we're gonna slowly shift back into a downward facing dog, alternating the heels down. Times here. We're going to come way up on our toes, drive the heels down. 5 times. Way up on our toes, drive the heels down. And then we're going to walk our feet to our hands, coming all the way back up. Right hand, grab the left wrist, pull to the right side. Reach up, grab the other wrist, pull to the other side. Reach up, forward fold, coming back down, hands to the ground. Step back into plank. Now we're gonna slowly lower down, pinching the elbows to the side, up dog or cobra. Flip the toes into downward facing dog. Shift back to plank. Slowly lower down. Up dog or cobra. Flip your toes. Downward facing dog. Back to plank. Slowly lower. Up dog or cobra. Downward dog. We're gonna do two more of those. Shift to plank. Slowly lower. Up dog or cobra. Flip the toes. Downward facing dog. Last one. Shift the plank. Pinch the elbows to the side. Slowly lower. Up dog or cobra. Flip the toes. Downward facing dog. All right. Hang out right here. We're gonna float the right heel up, driving the left heel down. Set that foot down. Left heel up, right heel down. Set the foot down. Shift back to plank. Slowly lower. Up dog or cobra. Flip your toes. Downward facing dog. Float your right heel up. Bring your right knee to your right elbow and hold. Float that leg up to the left elbow and hold. Float the leg up and swing it through into our runner's lunge here. Out right here. Plant that left hand down, reach up with the right, and bring the right hand down next to the left, reach up to the left, bring that hand down, straighten the leg, lift the toe, back into your lunge, reach up to the right, come down, reach up to the left, down, straighten the leg, lift the toe. We have two more here. Reach up to the right. Reach up to the left. Straighten your leg. Lift your toe. Reach up to the right. Reach up to the left. Straighten your leg. Lift your toe. And then we're going to shift forward onto that right foot. Now we have single leg touchdowns, 10 times. Coming down, back up. Keep your back nice and flat. And then when you're done with your 10, you're gonna shift back into our lunge. Wait for everyone to get done. There you go, hands to the ground. Step back to plank. Slowly lower to the ground. Up dog or cobra. Flip your toes. Downward facing dog. Other side. Left heel goes up. Shift the left knee to the left elbow and hold. Flip that leg up to the right elbow and hold. Flip the leg up. Swing it through into our runner's lunge and hold. Keep that back leg nice and straight. You can drive the heel back. Keep the leg straight. When you exhale, let your hips sink towards the ground. Let that stretch take place in the quad and hip flexors here, groin here. Plant the right hand, reach up to the left. Then slowly come down, reach up to the right. Down, straighten your front leg, lift your toe. Back into your lunge, reach up to the left. to the right. Straighten your leg. Lift the toe. Two more of those. Reach up to the left. And to the right. Straighten and lift. Reach up to the left. Reach up to the right. Straighten and lift. And then as we shift everything forward, come right up onto that left. We have 10 single leg touchdowns. And step back into your lunge when you're done with your 10. All right. Step back into plank. And we're going to come down to the tabletop. Knees to the ground. Extend your right arm out. Drive the left heel back. Crunch the elbow and knee together. Press them together. I'm going to extend all the way out, and we'll have 5 reps on this side. And then we'll come back to tabletop. Left arm out. Right heel goes back. Make sure your hips are square. Bring the elbow and knee together. Press them together. Hold. And extend all the way out. All the way in 5 times. Come back to tabletop. Flip your toes or tuck your toes. Press back into a downward dog. Pedal that out again 10 times. And then slowly walk your feet right to the outside of your hands into a squat stance. Grab the front of your shoes. Drop your butt. Keep your chest up. So heels on the ground. All right. Arms are the inside of the legs, pressing the knees out. We're going to straighten our legs, drop our chest and head. And then back into our gorilla squat. And we have 10 here. Nice and slow. Straighten your legs. If you don't feel this in your hamstrings, you can pull down. You can pull on your shoes and pull yourself down to get more of a stretch. Back into your squat. Straighten the legs. Back into your squat. Straighten. Squat. Straighten. Squat. Keep your heels down. Keep your heels down. Back things. Yeah. There you go. Straighten those legs. Back into your squat. You alright over there? Yeah, 2 more. Out here for the rest of the hour. Watch you guys work out. So, our strength work today. We have 3 exercises. We're going to work a minute at each exercise. We have deadlifts. All right, so we're going nice and slow going down. We'll have our weight. 1, 2, 3, pause, and then stand. All right, so if you have a fast 3 count, count to 4. Okay, so nice and slow, time under tension. Make sure you get the pause at the bottom, so let's not do this, okay? And the reason for that is if you do 30 reps in a minute over 3 sets, that's a lot of reps. You're gonna feel that really bad tomorrow, okay? So cut those reps in half, keep it under tension, all right, and create some strength through that movement, all right? right? And you'll use that same weight. So if I'm using this weight here, I'll do my deadlifts here, nice and slow, and pause, and then stand. We'll rest 30 seconds, and then we go right into our bicep curls for a minute. Then we'll rest 30 seconds, okay? And then I'm gonna flip this weight down like this. We're going to do upright rows for a minute, and then we'll rest a minute. We'll go through that 3 times. And then we'll go over the conditioning once we get there, all right? So I'm gonna end up turning it this way so I can see the clock. Poor planning. Poor planning and poor timing. Let's see here. What's that? All right, so we're starting off with deadlifts. We're going in 10 seconds here. And go, nice and slow going down. Pause at the bottom, keeping that belly button pulled in, and then stand at the top and squeeze your butt. Down nice and slow. And stand. 1, 2, 3, and pause, and stand. 1, 2, 3, and pause, stand. You can go at your own pace there. Now we got it dialed in a little bit. I think we're at like 6 reps here. It's a big difference in knocking them out. And rest. So then set your weight down. Give your grip a break. Shake those arms out. Get ready to do bicep curls now. Here we got 10 seconds. Don't be telling secrets back there. Everyone will know them. I think it picks up everything. You gotta go crash it. No, I'm just kidding. 3, 2, 1, and go. Curl, and slowly lower. Seconds.
If it started right or not, so I'm gonna fly.
Fifteen seconds. That out. And then, Susan, you're going to go to your band for this next one. Okay. Going to our upright rows. Upright rows. So if you have a light dumbbell at home, you can do upright rows on one side for 30 seconds and then switch and go to the other side. Okay? All right. And go. So drive the elbows up. Slowly come down. You can try it. You can try it. I'm not sure how it's gonna feel driving that elbow up. Feel all right? Keep that core tight as you pull up, and even tighter as you come down. You need to rest that core, rest it at the bottom. 30 seconds. Drive those elbows up, slowly lower. Fifteen seconds. have a minute. A minute of rest. Start to sweat. Starting to sweat a lot. Starting to sweat a lot. About midway through the bicep curls, I fell. Just start right down the side of my face.
You worked out harder in this, haven't
you? No, I've worked out the same. I mean, I used to work out 4 or 5 days a week. So this might be, it's definitely, it has been 5 days, sometimes six. And then if you count in 5Ks and kayaking and other stuff, there was like 3.5 weeks where I didn't have a day off, which is probably why my back is all jacked up right now. All right, here we go, back to our deadlifts. Gotta make sure we take that time off every now and then. And go. Pause at the bottom and stand. Nice and slow. We should get about 12, maybe 15 reps here, just like our bicep curls and our upright rows. We're doing the right tempo. Seconds. 15 seconds. Got time for one more rep here. And rest. One of the bicep curls next. Seconds before our bicep curls. Make sure you shake that out before we start. Ready? 3, 2, 1, and go. Curl it up. Keep those elbows tucked into the side, almost digging into your side. Keep the core tight, glutes engaged. Seconds here. Rest. Shake that out. Those elbows up, slowly lower. Seconds. Seconds. Last one. And rest. rest. Shake that out, minute rest. Make sure you stay hydrated. Getting ready to kick it up a notch after this next set. We got about 25 seconds here.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Back to our deadlifts. And go. Keep those shoulders back, nice and slow going down. Pause at the bottom. And stand and squeeze your butt. Nice and slow. And stand. Keep that core engaged. Belly button's pulled in.
No, she will. It sounds exactly like my kid.
Thirty seconds. Last one. And rest. 30 second rest, bicep curls. Seconds here, going back to our bicep curls. And go. Curl it up. Slowly lower down. Make sure you're using your biceps and you're not shrugging. Seconds. One more up here. And rest. 30 second rest. Fifteen seconds, upright rows. And then we'll get into our conditioning. Be scared. All right, here we go. Just like every other workout, it's as hard as you make it. And go. Got those elbows up. You get after it. It's hard. You get your burn. You get your results. You don't get after it, you don't get anything. You just get wet and sweaty. Dominican right there. Scooby-doo papa. About three more reps here. rest. You're going to set that heavy weight aside. All right, and if you're going to jump rope, go ahead and grab a jump rope. All right, if you're not going to jump rope, you got three options for you today. You can start with your feet wide, jump to the middle, and then back. Here are X hops, okay? You can go lateral hops side to side, or you can find the line, you can split those feet, and you can do switch foot jumps, okay? Or you can do 30 seconds of lateral hops, 30 seconds of switch foot jumps. Mix it up, okay? So we're gonna have 1 minute of jump rope or your modification, 1 minute of push-ups. Then we're gonna rest a minute, okay? Then we're gonna have 1 minute of ground to overhead, and that's where we can use that, okay? It's not gonna get your heart rate up, it's gonna work on that strength piece. But we'll go right into 1 minute of burpees, okay? And the goal on those burpees would be anywhere from 12 to 20 reps, okay? It's a wide range, right? But that should cover most fitness levels, 12 to 20 reps, okay? If you want to up the intensity on your jump rope, you can do double unders, you can do high knee jump ropes, okay? I'm gonna try jumping rope today, see how it goes. If not, then the next round, you'll see a box over here. You might see a box over here anyways. All right, so on the jump rope, you can up the intensity by double unders or high knees or boxer skips or something like that, okay? On the push-ups, don't need high intensity here. You just need to have good form and technique, okay? Make sure that when we start our push-ups, we start in this position here, the elbows are back, so we have a nice vertical forearm. And then as we press up, we squeeze our glutes and our core. As we lower, we keep the core engaged and then press back up, okay? If you need to hand release at the bottom to give you a little bit of momentum, that's fine as well. You need to be on your knees, right? If you're at home and you need to use the back of your couch to elevate, that's fine as well. All right, on the ground to overhead, I'm using lighter weight so I can get more reps in, but you can turn it into a strength workout by using heavier weight and doing less reps. And we're gonna alternate, all right? And then on the burpees, you can make those more intense by doing burpee box jumps, burpee tuck ups, or tuck jumps, or burpee step ups, okay? We're doing three rounds, sorry. So yeah, 1 minute, again, 1 minute of jump rope, 1 minute of push ups, 1 minute of rest, 1 minute of ground to overhead, 1 minute of burpees, 1 minute of rest, three rounds, okay? And we're going in 10 seconds. Start off nice and slow here. See how it feels.
Up, twisted.
And go. There you go. Feels like I haven't jumped rope in a long time. Yep. Oh! Being punished, 30 seconds. Ten seconds. We're going right into our push-ups. Three, two, one, and switch. Right into your push-up. Keep that core engaged. Seconds. 15 seconds. Three, two, one, rest. 1 minute rest, breathe. If you need to, move your equipment aside. Got 30 seconds here. We're starting off with ground to overhead. So we'll be here, standing over our weight. Non-working hand is out to the side, coming all the way overhead, back to the ground, switch to the other hand. Then we go right into our burpees. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, and go. Chest up at the bottom, switch arms, use your legs and your hips to help get that weight up overhead. Seconds, then the fun part starts. Three, two, one, right into your burpees. For the whole minute here. You got a minute rest. Round one done, two to go.
She didn't know store right there. She looks right in her.
Yeah. 20 seconds here. Back to our jump rope. 3, 2, 1, and go. Thank you.
Okay.
Three, two, one, and push ups.
Keep that core engaged. Modify your push ups as needed. Seconds. Ten seconds. Three, two, one, and rest. How hot is it? You know it. I'll make it more comfortable next time. I figure with this workout, I'll keep it nice and hot so I don't get a nice sweat on. Seconds. Ground overhead. Here we go. Going in three, two, one, and go. Seconds. Three, two, one, and switch. Burpees. Rest. 1 minute rest. Two down, one to go. Thirty seconds.
Yes. Good.
For another $700.
What part would we be answering?
Thank God this is the last round. All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, work. 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 Push up. Seconds. And rest. 1 minute. We got snatches or ground overhead. And back to our burpees to finish it up.
Does he know?
Two more minutes of work. Make sure you keep your chest up, butt down, back flat. 3, 2, 1, and go. Let's wait until the end here. Let's keep working. We'll catch up at the end. Yeah, 30 seconds. Last set. You don't finish until you hit 15 burpees. Let's go. 15. No time this time. 15 and you're done. Thank you. was the last one done, huh? Tabletop position, slide your right knee up in between your hands, slide the left leg back, and come down, stretching that hip and back out. It's every day for me. Swimming Lake Jamie, Lake Fuller. Lake, that was almost Evan's name.
What, Lake?
Lake.
Lake.
I told Anna, I was like, come on, everywhere he goes, he's Lake Fuller. Come on. Nope. Hang out here for a little longer. Roll over onto that hip. Come back to tabletop if you want to. Bring that left knee in between the hands. Just slide around here. Ooh. Holy crap. Slowly roll onto that hip. You want, you can come up here. We just stretch this, that kind of. Nice work, ladies. Sorry, I had to add those 15 burpees at the end. There was a lot of talking going on at the end of the workout. Shouldn't have been talking that much. Should have been out of breath. I don't know, you're forming full words and full sentences. I can run the tape back. Just loop it. See, now you're done. On with your day.